In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Today we celebrate Saint Josepha, Bishop and Martyr. And today we offer this Holy Mass for Joseph Sandowski. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. Stir up in your church, we pray, O Lord, the spirit that filled Saint Josaphat, and he laid down his life for the sheep, so that through his intercession, we too may be strengthened by the same Spirit and not be afraid to lay down our life for others. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Philemon. Beloved, I have experienced much joy and encouragement from your love, because the hearts of the holy ones have been refreshed by you, brother. Therefore, although I have the full right in Christ to order you to do what is proper, I rather urge you out of love, being as I am Paul, an old man, and now also a prisoner for Christ Jesus. I urge you on behalf of my child Onesimus, whose father I have become in my imprisonment, who was once useless to you but is now useful to both you and me. I am sending him, that is, my own heart, back to you. I should have liked to retain him for myself so that he might serve me on your behalf in my imprisonment for the gospel, but I did not want to do anything without your consent, so that the good you do might not be forced but voluntary. Perhaps this is why he was away from you for a while, that you might have him back forever. No longer as a slave, but more than a slave, a brother, beloved especially to me, but even more so to you, as a man and in the Lord. So if you regard me as a partner, welcome him as you would me. And if he has done you any injustice or owes you anything, charge it to me. I, Paul, write this in my own hand. I will pay. May I not tell you that you owe me your very self? Yes, brother, may I profit from you in the Lord. Refresh my heart in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob. Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob. The Lord secures justice for the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who were bowed down. The Lord loves the just. The Lord protects strangers. Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob. The fatherless and the widow he sustains, but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever, your God, O Zion, through all generations. Alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I am the vine, you are the branches, says the Lord. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Asked by the Pharisees when the kingdom of God would come, Jesus said in reply, "The coming of the kingdom of God cannot be observed, and no one will announce, 'Look, here it is,' or 'There it is.' For behold, the kingdom of God is among you." Then he said to his disciples, "The days will come when you will long to see one of the days of the Son of Man, but you will not see it. There will be those who will say to you, 'Look, there he is,' or 'Look, here he is.' Do not go off, do not run in pursuit, for just as the lightning flashes and lights up the sky from one side to the other, so will the Son of Man be in his day. But first he must suffer greatly and be rejected by this generation." The Gospel of the Lord. The kingdom of God is among you. The kingdom is present when the king is present, and Jesus is the king. And where is the king? If we found the king, we found the kingdom of God. Where is Jesus? Jesus is present in a special way in the Eucharist. The sacrament of the Eucharist is real presence of Jesus Christ. Jesus is present when we are here together in his name, in the middle of us. He is present. He is present inside of us, in our conscience, when that conscience is conscience with good formation. Jesus is present in our daily life. And we need to discover him in order to enter in communion with him and enjoy the kingdom of heaven. From here on the earth, it's possible to enter in communion with the King here and prepare our soul for the definitive encounter with him in the eternal life. The kingdom of God is among you. This is the message that Jesus said to us today in this gospel. Do you want to discover the kingdom of God? Do you want to enter in a good relationship with the King? It's possible, but you need to have faith in him. You need to follow his teaching. When you read the sacred scriptures, You found the key to, when we said at the end of the gospel of the Lord, the words of Jesus, he's present. When we celebrate any sacrament, he is present too. It's Jesus who forgives you when you come to the sacrament of penance. It's Jesus who baptizes when we celebrate baptism. The kingdom of God is among you. Open your eyes, open your heart, and discover the kingdom of God from here on the earth. Let us pray in silence. As the martyrs trusted in God's word, we trust that our prayers will be heard.
That the hearts of our leaders in the church may be refreshed in the Lord by the love we show and the good deeds we do in Jesus' name, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord, who secures justice for the oppressed and gives food to the hungry, may raise up world leaders who will be his instruments of compassion and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may understand that the kingdom of God is already among us and within us as we look forward in hope to the coming of Christ in his final glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering greatly and for those who are persecuted and rejected by this generation, that Jesus may be with them for comfort and strength, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone before us, that they may be quickly purified to see the day of the Son of Man in the kingdom of heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the eternal rest of Joseph Samdowski and Ermilia Estrada. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for this parish community and for our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord. O God, your church is founded on Christ and made firm by your martyrs. May these prayers that we place before you be supported by their prayers and answered by your will through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Most merciful God, pour out your blessing upon these offerings and confirm us in the faith that Saint Josaphat professed by the shedding of his blood, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr Josaphat, pour out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear your witness through Christ our Lord. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for And this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have felt us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Agnus Dei.
tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. I only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May this heavenly table, O Lord, bestow on us a spirit of fortitude and peace, so that, following Saint San Josaphat's example, we may willingly spend our lives working for the honor and unity of the Church, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.